Better.
Are you recording? So you're being awkward, I see. If you're being awkward, I'm awkwardly going to eat this roast beef. What is that?
Welcome to Fun Fridays with Danny and Shanny. I'm Shanny.
And I'm Danny. I was about to choke on a new joke.
And let's have some fun. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, so today for Fun Friday, we're going to do a story time video of the day that we got married because tomorrow is our 12-year wedding anniversary. Did you remember?
Of course I did.
Or did I just remind you just now?
Of course I did.
Dumb arguments will resume next week, but today we just wanted to do this because it's fun and it's our anniversary and we want to look back on that day and tell you the story of our wedding day car crash. Car crash on my wedding day. Are you ready?
Yeah.
So once upon a time in the land of Manti, Utah, 2004, July 2nd, 2004, Danny and I were married.
What time was it?
10:30 a.m. Danny and I were married. And after the wedding, after the ceremony,
Wait. You're skipping over all the good stuff.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, oh yeah.
What's the good stuff?
That morning, early morning, number one, I hadn't slept at all that night, so I played Xbox all night. And then Shan called me about, what?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Because you got up crazy early, like 4 in the morning, to get your hair.
I got up at 3 to go get my hair done.
So she got up at 3 in the morning to go get her hair done. Okay. Then called me. Hey, you awake? Of course I'm awake. Yep, just woke up. All refreshed. So I came over to her house, her parents' house at the time. And her hair looked freaking gorgeous. All right. And everyone's rushing around and getting ready. So we all pack into our individual cars. And we make the hour and a half trip down to Manti.
We had a really long drive there, and on the way there, we were almost there, started this series of events throughout the day with, we met a lot of police officers that day, let's just say that. So the first thing that happened, the first time, right before we got to the temple, the Manti temple, which is where we got married, my stepdad, I was in the waiting room waiting to be married, and it's kind of like a sacred ceremony in our religion, so.
So we're not gonna talk about it.
Yeah, it's just kind of an in our temple type of thing. But anyway, my stepdad
was. Can I just say one thing?
What?
I was waiting in one part for her to stop crying like
I'm getting there.
Boob.
I'm getting there. It's not time yet. You can't tell the story. You're getting it all mixed up.
You cut right to the middle, and we were married.
I didn't think that stuff was. I want to get to the good stuff.
This
car crash.
The good stuff. You have to build up on the little stuff to make the big thing.
So anyway, we're waiting to get married in the temple, and for one of the parts in the temple, you need witnesses there, just like you would at a normal wedding, right?
Yes.
Or like, you know, the father would give away the daughter or whatever. So that's kind of was my stepdad's role. So we were waiting for him, and it was time to get married, and he was nowhere to be found. Because apparently, he got pulled over going like 90 miles an hour.
More like 190 miles.
Was it really? I believe it. It was probably 100 at least.
It was at least 100.
And so that happened. So so we were a little bit late starting the ceremony, but that's okay. It was really funny. So after Rob finally showed up, it was time for me to go to the sealing room where we were gonna get married. And I had one of the temple worker ladies with me, and she starts walking me to the room, and I lose it. I start bawling, I'm crying, like I'm so emotional, I'm so happy, I'm so emotional. And she's probably like 95 years old, she's so old. But she stops me and she's like, sweetie, you need to stop crying, you need to buck up and be a good wife for your husband. He should never see you cry. You should always have dinner on the table at 5 o'clock. Like, it's so old fashioned and so like, no.
I didn't know that.
You don't cry. You do not cry. I was like, lady, it's my wedding day. Of course, I'm not like mad or sad. I'm happy. Like, these are happy tears. But then right after that though, I turned the corner while she was walking me, and that's when I see Danny waiting for me to take me into the room with him. And when I saw him, we both lost it. He even got teary-eyed, and he doesn't cry very often, but he really choked up too, and it was really, really sweet. So that moment beautiful. Right there was really a beautiful moment, because it was almost symbolic of like having a hard life that I had growing up. Like, that lady was the symbol of that. And then turning the corner and seeing Danny and seeing my future and seeing, aww.
Aww.
So this is love. So this is love.
After the ceremony, it was July 2nd, and we live in the desert, so it was very hot. We took pictures afterwards for like an hour, and were just sweat Dying. Balls afterwards. And that was really fun. So then we started driving back to where we lived, because the reception would be that night. So on the drive back, we stopped and we got some lunch with the family, kind of had a little luncheon with just whoever was there at the actual ceremony of us getting married. And that was really nice. And Danny and I decided to leave a little bit earlier than the rest of them so that we could go home and get ready for the reception. So we leave early, we are on the road, out in the middle of nowhere, in the desert, there's no phone service, there's no nothing, it's like 110 degrees, it's super awful. And from what I remember, I'll tell you what I remember, and then Danny's gonna have to fill in the blanks. So I fell asleep.
Basically, I'll tell you what really happened.
Yeah, I fell asleep, and I remember at one point waking up, and I had fallen asleep like this. So like my
little
face,
Aereo, huh?
Wait,
Suzuki Aereo.
Let me tell my part
well,
first.
They have to know what the car is.
Let me tell my part first. So I was laying right here, and the window was right there. So I was like resting my face on the window, and something woke me up, and I don't even know what, because nothing happened to wake me up, and I was dead tired. I don't know how I woke up, but I did. I woke up, and I like look over at Danny, and I'm like, Danny, I'm really cold. And I don't know why, because I was not cold. It was 110 degrees outside, but I woke up and I'm like, I'm really cold. And so the next thing I know, I'm falling back asleep facing Danny now. And the last thing I remember is him putting the coat over me, and then I fell asleep. And then I woke up to the loudest crash. Like, I thought we were dying. I remember screaming and like yelling to Danny, being like, it's okay, we just got married. We'll be together again, because we just barely got married. So we'll be together again. I'll see you in heaven. I love you. We're together forever. It's okay. Like, I really thought I was dying. It felt like, because we were going about 95. Yeah, you tell how the crash happened.
So we had a little Suzuki Aereo, which is pretty much like a little plastic car, okay? Little bugger. I remember following a bigger, like, jacked up size truck, and I think they were helping move somebody because they were following a minivan. The minivan stopped abruptly and wanted to do a U-turn. Then the big pickup truck followed him, stopped abruptly. I was following very too close, and I didn't stop abruptly. We went up under his wheel well, okay? Which, that's what popped the window in on Shannon. Tore the entire front side
my
of the car
end where I was, right, where
off, because it was all plastic, so it wasn't built to do that. I swerve over in the other lane, because I'm just reacting now. There was another truck coming at us, so I threaded the freaking needle in between two
this
vehicles.
This was going 90 plus
we're
miles
going,
an hour.
We're going super fast.
So we had already right been through. Hit on my side, right?
Yeah, so I put us up and under. Threaded the needle through the two trucks and spun out in the dirt in front of the guy that I just nailed in the back.
And seriously, had I not woken up and...
Yeah, you would have glass all over.
And
you.
Like, I wouldn't have a face. And that window was gone and shattered. Yeah. And we got out of the car afterwards, and Danny didn't suffer any injuries at all. And the only injury I suffered was this. Just a little cut on my heel, and that's it.
Nobody else in the other trucks or anything in it. Nobody got hurt.
Like, going that fast, hitting that hard where I was sitting, like, luckily, because there was no cell phone service, thankfully, we had left a little bit earlier than my family, so we knew that they were going to be coming soon behind us. And so we just waited for like a half an hour till the rest of them caught up. And
that was a really spectacular time of the two of us in our wedding garb.
Yeah.
By a busted freaking vehicle.
You were in your cops. Suit, right? I wasn't. I was in a different dress.
You were in like your after wedding dress.
Yeah, and I was like crying to the cop, and I'm like, I just got married an hour ago. And it was so terrifying.
It sucked. And then our whole, both families came rolling right past us. Mm-hmm. They all got out freaking out, and they're like, oh my gosh, you guys just died, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, so then we realized that it was getting late, and we had a reception to be to that night. And so my stepdad was so kind, seriously, you guys.
He took care of
to
it all.
To stay there with our car in the 110 degree heat with no air conditioning because he didn't have a car with him.
Right.
He only had our car, which was now broken, and he waited for 4 hours for the tow truck to get there and to take him and to take him back to where we lived. And it just, I will forever be grateful. He didn't complain. He didn't, he didn't even say, he didn't even question it. He just was like, get in Julie's car and go with Julie. She'll drive you home and I'll see you at the reception. So that was awesome. So we go home, we kind of rest for a little bit because I was really shaken up. I was really like traumatized. And I didn't even want to go to my reception. Like, by the time we got home, the long drive home, I had been replaying things in my mind and like telling, I remember talking to my sister and being like, does this mean that our marriage is doomed? Because we got in a car accident right after we got married. We totaled our car right after we got married. And she's like, you know that old saying that if it rains on your wedding day, then you'll have a great marriage? Well, you guys did that times like 20, so I think you're good. Like, things like that. Like, I just was freaking out. I was so young at the time. I was 19, by the way, when we got married. He was 21 and I was 19. So we get home and we're just kind of resting because, again, I'm traumatized and Danny is too. And it ended up that we were a little bit late to our reception because
like
we were
an hour late.
Resting, and a lot of it was Danny trying to convince me to go. I didn't even want to go. Like, I was so done. I was like, no, I got married today and then I almost died today. I just was in a place of like terror, and like, I didn't even want to get back into a car. I was freaking out because we were going to go to our honeymoon that night, and then we're going to have to fly to a different part of our honeymoon a week later. Like, I just was freaking out. So after a lot of convincing, Danny finally got me to the reception. We walk in late, everyone applauds, of course, because they're all been there waiting for like
waiting
an hour.
For us.
I feel so bad. I'm so sorry if you were those people that were waiting on me. That
but
was
thanks.
My fault. I had a major anxiety attack and that was my fault. So get to the reception, and the funny thing is that we did the whole thing where you stand in a line. Do they do that outside of Utah? I don't think they do.
No, I'm sure they do.
Do they?
Yeah.
I don't know. Where the bride and groom stand in a line with their parents and their bridesmaids and all that crap.
And everybody comes through
and congratulates. So the line went like this. The line started with my stepdad and my mom, and then me, and then Danny, and then Danny's parents. So my stepdad would be the first one to greet a person and say that they got in a car accident. And then my mom would be the next one to like tell the details of the car accident because her daughter almost died and she was so worried about me. And so by the time they got to me, it wasn't, oh, congratulations on getting married. It was like, oh, congratulations for not dying. You lived. Like, thank you. But I did get married today.
It was more of a survival reception.
Yeah.
Kind of thing.
Which is great, really. I mean, how grateful were we to even be alive after that? Like,
sure.
What an amazing story that was. So our reception was a blur. I don't really remember it. I was still really shaken
there was
up.
There dancing, I think.
We danced together.
Yeah.
It's really sweet. So after the reception was done, I remember Danny's mom pulls me aside and she's like, listen, you guys have had a really long day. This is not a normal wedding day. Like, maybe you guys should just stay home tonight and drive to the hotel tomorrow, because we were going to a hotel that was about an hour away, and the reception went late because of us, and we were exhausted. We hadn't slept all night. Neither of
us
had.
We didn't even get back to the
We almost died, house, you know,
all like those things. Midnight.
Yeah, no, what, like one.
Was it
we
one?
Got back to the house, but before we went back to the house, I remember his mom pulling me aside and being like, you guys don't have to get to the hotel tonight. You can have your fun at home if you want. She really did. It was really cute.
What do you have a home? Like, your parents' home.
Well, my parents' home, yeah. My room, my old room. And so, but then we were like, no, it's okay. We'll just hurry and drive up there and then we'll be rested, right? No big deal. So we run home. It's like 1 o'clock by the time we get back home. And I hadn't even packed yet because I had planned on packing before the reception. But since I was freaking out and not thinking I was going to live, I didn't. And so we got home around 1 a.m. We just threw everything basically in my room
back
into a big suitcase and into the car and just started driving to Park City where our hotel was. So it's about 3
in
the morning.
By the way, at about 1 a.m., right, we got there, did I tell you this? Mm-hmm. My dad calls me, you know, you don't really have to go up tonight.
I didn't know that.
Oh, I thought I told you that.
No.
Yeah. You don't really have to go up tonight. You should maybe just rest and get home tomorrow. I'm like, ah, yeah, well, we just packed and...
We should have listened.
I got lots of Dr. Pepper. We'll just go up there.
We should have listened because we ended up leaving my house about 3 a.m. and we're driving up to Park City.
By the way, in Utah, after 12, everything shuts down.
Yeah.
Okay. So there ain't nobody on the road, especially this road that leads up to a place called Park City in Utah. It's...
Oh, yeah. It's nothing. Like out in the middle of nowhere. Yeah, it's up in the mountains.
Yeah, it's up in the mountains.
And it's like out of the... Out of nowhere.
There's no... Yeah. It's one-way road, no lights, no nothing, zero.
And we should have listened to his parents because we started driving at about 3 a.m. So about 3:30 a.m., we were like halfway there almost, and we get pulled over. And we're already driving my sister's car. We didn't even have my car anymore, which means that we weren't even registered on that car. We had to take Julie's car. And so we're like freaking out, like, oh my gosh, we're not even registered on this car. We're gonna get in so much trouble, blah, blah, blah. So the officer slowly walks up and Danny rolls down his window. And before he could say anything, I was like, sir, hi, how are you tonight? Listen.
No, make it right.
Oh, okay. Did I swear?
You just got married and now you gotta let us go.
I did.
Was like, listen, we just got in a car accident.
I know. I was like, sir, seriously, I got married this morning and then I got in a car accident and my dad got pulled over and then I was late for my reception.
But
and
she
then,
wasn't calm like this. She was literally crying.
And I was bawling. I was like, listen, please don't give us a ticket. Please just let me get to my hotel and enjoy my honeymoon with my husband because today has been a day of hell. I know it's my wedding day, but it has been hell and I'm gonna need you to just let us go, not give us any lectures, not give us a ticket, not give us anything and just let me go. And he's like, go on ahead. Congratulations. And he let us go.
I actually honestly think, I don't even think I was speeding. I think he pulled us over because we were the only bloody ones out there at 3 a.m.
Yeah.
So.
But we were freaking out because of the registration, but he didn't check anything. Normally they'll check it and then let you go.
He didn't ask for my license.
But he saw my face and he's like, okay, congratulations. Get to your hotel. I'm like, thank you.
For a minute, I thought he was going to say, I'm going to flip my lights. You guys just follow me up and let's just boogie there. Yeah. For a second I did.
So we got to the hotel at 4 a.m. and the front desk wasn't even open. And so like they had to call somebody who comes down and they're basically in their pajamas.
I forgot about that.
Somebody that just manages it there that must stay there because they were in their jammies and came down at 4 a.m. to take us to our room and stuff. And it was just crazy. So, and then we were up till 7, 8 a.m.
So I don't know. It was a blur after it. Anything after the wreck, it was just a blur, whatever, just blah.
Yeah, so it was a really great day. But the thing is, you guys, is that, oh, I feel like I'm going to get emotional all of a sudden.
Oh, no, not over your wedding. That would be weird.
Remember when I shoved the cake in your face, too?
Oh, yeah, we didn't tell him about the reception.
Danny was really nice when we fed each other the cake, you know, when you do. He just placed it in my mouth real nicely. And right before I did it, I'll show you some pictures right now, but right before I did it, I whispered to him and I said, I'm so sorry. And then I took the cake, shoved it in his nose, and it was hilarious.
I was smelling cake for the next week, by the way.
But then he got me back by kissing me right away, so I got all over my face too. Anyway, what else? What else about that day do you remember?
Oh, sparklers.
Oh, that was fun. Yeah.
We had all of our, the family outside. I didn't even know this. Did you know this? Did you plan that?
I think I did.
Oh.
I don't know.
When we were walking out of the reception area, which was at the Provo Library, so it had a huge ballroom, which was really cool because it was really big.
It had a huge staircase out front where we would have to come out to run to our car to do the traditional get in our car and run.
Stuff.
Yeah.
So
or get in Julie's car and run because our car didn't.
By the way, thank you, Julie. That was very nice.
Julie, thank you for giving us your car. Seriously.
All the family, whoever was left, all got sparklers because it was so close to the 4th of July. So they were all there and there was sparklers, so that was really cool. The coolest part, though, is that the major parade route is right on that road that we were on. And there were people setting up a couple of days earlier. So all the spectators that were waiting to save spots for the parade in the morning, all started getting up and cheering and honking horns and stuff like that.
That was so much fun.
That
they
was,
all had their own sparklers
and hollering.
We felt so famous. And then when we drove off, we drove through the parade thing.
Yeah.
And so our car was all decorated so people knew. And so everyone was just cheering us on.
It was fun.
It was really fun.
A lot of fun.
Okay, so what was your favorite part of the day?
When we got in bed.
That's a shocker.
Yeah. No, it was really good.
Okay, so I hope you enjoyed our story time of our wedding day car crash and our wedding day in general. And
our wedding day survival guide.
Yeah, and I think we've told you our engagement, we've told you holding hands. I don't think we've told you our first kiss yet, and that's one that Danny loves to tell. So tell us in the comments below if you want us to tell that story, and we will be happy to do that for you. We hope you enjoyed this. We'll see you next Friday for another fun Friday, probably more dumb arguments. And then join me every Tuesday through Friday for videos. And please subscribe to my channel. Please get my message spread out there and have all your friends subscribe. And please give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, because it really helps me out when you do that. So, we love you guys and happy anniversary tomorrow.
Happy anniversary to you too.
I love you. And I'm really glad that we
survived.
Got married and that we survived and that we've had those rocky times, because it's made us that much closer, and that's what's made us the strong couple that we are. We also got in an accident a year after we got married.
Any other follies you want to throw out there?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
No, that's all. So happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary too. Love you.
You're beautiful.
You're worth it.
And I am too. Thanks for watching. Bye. Bye. You didn't do your thing.
We don't do that, only on fun Fridays. You want me to do it?
This is a fun Friday.
Oh.
You know what love was meant to be. The kind of love to last forever. And I want you here with me. From tonight until the end of time, you should know everywhere I go, always on my mind, in my heart, in my soul. You're the meaning in my life, you're the inspiration, you bring feeling to my life. Inspiration. I wanna have you hear me. I wanna have you hear me saying, no one needs you more than I need you. And I know that it's pain to see. Now I know that I need you here with me. From tonight until the end of time, you should know everywhere I go, you're always on my mind, you're in my heart, in my soul. You're the meaning in my life. You're inspiration. You bring feeling to my life. You're the inspiration. I wanna have you hear me. I wanna have you hear me saying, no one needs you more than I need. You're the meaning in my life. You're the inspiration. You bring feeling to my life.